Hello friends, in this video we will solve this problem, Day of the Programmer in Java Programming Language. So we have given a range of years which is from 1700 to 2700. So in this range, before 1918 they were using Julian calendars, and after 1918 they were using Gregorian calendars. So 1918 is the year in which the transition between Julian and Gregorian calendars occur, and the concept of leap year in Julian calendar system is different from the Gregorian calendar system. So the concept is like this: Julian calendar system, the leap year is a year which is perfectly divisible by 4, and in the Gregorian calendar system the leap year is having some additional conditions. Here you will see if the divisible by 400 and divisible by 4 and not divisible by 100. So these are the conditions. You can read these conditions on your own to make it more clear. So we have to find the 256 day of the given year according to the calendar system and the leap year system they were using at that time. So for example, here we have given 2017 year. So the 256 day of this year is 13th of 9 2017. So this is the day of the programmer of this year. And they have given another examples also, an explanation also here. So these are the explanation here they have given. So 1980s was the special case where the transition between the both the calendar system occurs. So it is a special case where the day of the programmer will be very special. So you will see in the function. So if 1980s, that is year equal to 1980s, then we have to return the date, which is 26th of 9 1980s. So this is a very special case where it is only for the year 1980s. So I will also write here that it is a special case. So otherwise the day of the programmer will be on 12th of 9 or 13th of 9, that is 12th of September or 13th of September. So for that we will check if the year is leap or not. For that we will take an integer and we will store the mod of 4 in that year by mod in that. So we can use it to find the year is leap or not, and we will store the mod of 100 in the in this variable remainder of 100, and we will store the remainder of 400 in this variable, that is by doing the mod of that given year. And we will use this data for our function, and after that we will take a string, and in that we will store the value of a given year in a string format. That is, this year will be stored in this string as a string, and then after we will take some other strings. So we will take this string to return the given date, that is the day of the programmer of a given year, and we will take another string, and in this string we will store 12th of 9, and we will give another dot, and we will use this string in the function afterwards. So if the year is greater than 1980, that is if the year is in the Gregorian calendar system, then we will check if the year given year is leap year or not. And the condition for that is if the remainder of 4, that is the remainder of 4 is equal to 0 and remainder of 100 is not equal to 0. So this is one condition for which if both of these conditions are satisfying, then the year will be leap. And another condition is that if the remainder of 100 is equal to 0, then it has to satisfy another condition, that is remainder of 400 is also equal to 0. So either of these conditions satisfies, the year will be leap, and we have to return this ddmmyy, and we will add, the date will be this and the year will be the given year, that is this year. So we have taken this year into the string, so it will be like this ddmm.concat. So we will use concat method and we will concat the string yy, and we will after return the string, that is return ddmmyy. So this was the conditions for 1980s, if the year is greater than 1980s, and else if the remainder of 4 is equal to 0. So this is the condition for the year which are lesser than 1980. So if the year is lesser than 1980, the condition for the leap year is like this. If the remainder of 4 is equal to 0, then the year will be leap. So we have to return ddmmyy, that is, and then after we will concat ddmm to the given year, that is yy, and we will return the string from here. And if the both of these conditions are not satisfying, then the year is not leap, and we have to return 13th of 9 dot plus yy. So this is the completion of our function. We will just run it, let's see if it works or not. So first three stage cases have passed, we will submit. So all the test cases are passing. So this is the function you can use to solve this problem. So if you want more videos on HackerRank solutions, please subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching.